If you don't know what a game engine is, then you can take a look at this video about Unity game engine. Let's talk about Godot. As a quick recap, a game engine is an engine for games, except the engine isn't an engine at all, but rather the frame part of the car that you add more stuff to, almost like they could have just called it a framework. Because many games can be made from the same frame, many game studios made their own game engines so that they can have more than one game. This led to the business of making game engines for other people to use, so that not everyone had to make their own engine. Many of these are big companies: Unity, Unreal, which is made by Fortnite, Source Engine has its classics. Godot was the private game engine developed by Juan Linetsky and Ariel Manzur for their consulting company, Codenix, making it a noteworthy Latin American contribution to the game development industry, just like the Zeebo. The name comes from the play Waiting for Godot, which does happen occasionally, but the real reason why it's named that is because it's constantly improving, unlike other game engines that don't do that. Also, maybe the Ace Attorney character. The engine was more or less developed through the careers of the developers since 2001, changing to the needs of each game that was built on the engine. In 2014, with Linetsky planning on moving out of Argentina with no plans on selling the engine or competing with the massively successful Unity Corporation, Godot was made public on GitHub and officially became an open source project, which meant you were no longer allowed to not like it because then it would technically be everyone's fault. But the open source format works well for Godot. Now instead of just two developers, there's an entire community of developers changing the engine to fit the needs of new games. In the years following 2014, with Linetsky as lead developer, Godot saw itself an ever-increasing list of volunteer contributors throughout its many revisions, and throughout all of this produced an impressive repertoire of games such as Sonic Colors Ultimate and the game in the tutorial. The most recent version, as of the time of this recording, is Godot 4.1, but I'm going to have to make this a short video or else Godot 4.2 is going to come out. In Godot 4, like in previous versions, everything is a node, and nodes can be in nodes, and a tree of nodes can be a scene, which can be a node within other nodes within scenes. This animation player node is in this Shinji scene, which is a node in the main scene. A node is simply just an anything that you yourself get to decide how to define or organize, and it's a good name for it. Rather than everything having to be a game object or an actor, anything can be a node. What this means is that the engine gives you a tree of nodes, some of which can be put together as scenes, with each node having one script attached to it, and what you do with that is your business. One thing about Godot is that everything is actually Godot. Goodbye text editor, goodbye file explorer. The default programming language custom for Godot is called GDScript, which is fairly Pythonic. This does mean that it's very beginner-friendly, though. While an intermediate programmer can put together a prototype in a mere matter of hours, it's a design choice that fits with the simple set of tools that Godot provides. You want to move and slide? Use the move and slide function. Godot also has signals for communicating about things that happen between nodes. Because Godot only really adds features when an actual game needs it, it's fairly lightweight. Though, looking at the code, people have pointed out that there are flaws in its performance, as opposed to game engines like Unity, where you're not allowed to look at the code. Godot 4 specifically also has and will have some cool features, like directly importing 3D models from Blender. Here is a 3D model from Blender in Desmos Graphing Calculator, which is a completely different type of thing and has nothing to do with the video. Godot was born from the developers' desire to solve their own problems, and it remains as such, but on the international scale. Being open source doesn't mean that it's without structure. There are still production managers to post random pop culture references in the group chat. Rather, by being open source, there is a sense of understanding, because the developers are you, and surely you understand yourself. Anyway, the longer I talk about the features in Godot, the quicker this video is going to become irrelevant. This one only lasted 1 year. I could just say that despite its history, Godot is still only in its early stages of development, and it has a lot of potential, but a long way to go. But then I might as well not say anything at all.
Chito Sekkin, 距離およそ2万!
では、作戦開始!